The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus told his disciples this parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a landowner who went out at dawn to hire laborers for his vineyard. After agreeing with them for the usual daily wage, He sent them into his vineyard. Going out about 9 o'clock, the landowner saw others standing idle in the marketplace, and he said to them, "You too, go into my vineyard, and I will give you what is just." So they went off. And he went out again around noon and around 3 o'clock and did likewise. Going out about 5 o'clock, the landowner found others standing around and said to them, "Why do you stand here idle all day?" And they answered, "Because no one has hired us." And he said to them, "You too, go to my vineyard." When it was evening, the owner of the vineyard said to his foreman, "Summon the laborers and give them their pay, beginning with the last and ending with the first." When those who had started about 5 o'clock came, each received the usual daily wage. So when the first came, they thought that they would receive more. But each of them also got the usual wage. And on receiving it, they grumbled against the landowner, saying, "These last ones work only 1 hour, and you have made them equal to us who bore the day's burden and the heat." And the master said to one of them in reply, "My friend, I am not cheating you. Did you not agree with me for the usual daily wage? Now take what is yours and go. What if I wish to give the last the same as you? Or I am not free to do so as I wish with my own money? Or are you envious because I am generous?" Thus, the last will be first, and the first will be last. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, the gospel for today, taken from the Gospel of Matthew 21-7, is actually the answer of Jesus to Peter, who asked him, "Lord, we have left everything, our families, our properties. So what is our reward in the next life?" And of course, Peter was expecting a reward from God because he offered his whole life to the ministry of Jesus. And this was the answer of Jesus. May isa ka landowner, pwede yan mamasugo sa iyang manager, foreman, to go to marketplace, to look for, to hire laborers for his vineyard. He went out 6 o'clock in the morning, and he found some kaginimbitarya, "Go to my vineyard." Pero nag-agree sila sa sining statement, 6 o'clock, first batch. "Kadto ka mo sa akong talamnan sang ubas, tagaanta ka mo sang minimum wage, like 300 or 500 pesos, whatever." So from 6 o'clock to 6 in the morning to 6 in the evening, 500 pesos. Second batch, 9 o'clock. Kadto siya sa marketplace. May nakita siya dito. But when you go back to the text, wala na siya naghambal sa minimum wage. Kundi naghambal siya, "I will give you what is just." when you read the text. First batch, I give you the usual wage. Second batch, not the usual wage, but what is right, what is just. Second batch, group, some 12 o'clock, the same. I'll give you what is right. Fourth batch, 3 o'clock, I'll give you what is right. Fifth batch, 5 o'clock, 1 hour lang ilaobra. I'll give you what is right. Karon sang gabi, sang sirom na, 6 o'clock, hambal sang master, sa iya foreman, siya nagwa, pero this time ang masweldo, iya manager. Ang sweldo huy sila. Pero hindi natin pagsundo ng aton nga mga economic nga mga plan nga ano ni nga system. Of course unahon mo ang una, pero balis karon naton unahon naton ang last. Sa taga-Asia. Pila hatag ko minimum. Hatagan ng 5 o'clock, hinatagan ng 3 o'clock minimum. Pagdabot sa first batch, 6 o'clock sa aga, nagreklamo sila. Nga tidamo amon ubra, lawid, nga pareho amon sweldo. And then, ang sabat sang amo, amo ini, my friend, I am not cheating you. Did you not agree with me for the usual daily wage? Now take what is yours and go. What if I wish to give this last one the same as you? Meaning to say, just ako katama. Hindi bala ako pwede maging generous? Justice is not against generosity. Justice is you give what is due. Generosity, napasubrahan mo. So, pareho kamutanan. Pero ako na lang yung ma-decide kung paano ko exercise ang akong generosity. Maakig ka bala kay generous ako? Or are you envious because I am generous? Boom! Peter, amuning parable. Damo imo obra, nag-expect ka sang reward. For I tell you, Peter, sobra pamahatag ko da sa imo sa gina-expect mong reward. And you know the answer of Jesus, I remember. Everyone, Jesus said, everyone who left houses or brothers or sisters or father or mother or wife or children or lands for my name's sake will receive 100 times and will inherit eternal life. So therefore, we meditate on the generosity of God. Gakray lang kita sang justice kung may scarcity of resources. Kung may abundance of resources, why ka nagakray sang justice? Kaya kung may scarcity, posible ang imo to, kwaon, kagihatag sa iban. That's why gareklamo ka. Kaya ang generosity dito, injustice sa imo. Because of the scarcity of resources. But in the kingdom of heaven, wala sang scarcity, abundance. So don't worry, Peter. Damo dito. Damo ihatag sa imo, sobra pa. Doga mo na si Jesus, hambalya kay Peter. So God is generous, superabundant. Ang iya love sa aton. And therefore, we would like to imitate His generosity. And I've listed 8 ways or benefits of generosity. Number one, kung generous kita like God, we become more like Christ. Of course, ang ultimate purpose kin natin sa kalibutan is to be like Christ, is to be like our God because we have been created in His image and likeness. Not only in physical features or intellect or free will, we become like God when we give. Because God is love. You can give without loving, but you cannot love without giving. So if you want to be like God, shortcut is to give. That's why when we give, we are generous. we become more like Christ. Another way, of course, is forgive. When you forgive, you become like God. Don't forget, forgive the other. Second benefit of generosity is we gain freedom from materialism. Tuod na, isan ako. Kung ang focus ko, resources, kag properties, money, slave ako sang money. Hindi ko pagbuyan. Hindi ako maging generous. Pero makita ako nga akong master sa nga akong material and resources, kung maging generous ako. So hindi ako slave sa nga akong property. Ako ang Lord sa nga akong property. And I can decide kung anong himuon ko dira. That's why when you are generous, you gain freedom from materialism. Third reason, when we are generous, joy is infused sa atong tagipuso. And then you know that, many of you, when you help other people, may deep joy. Hindi pleasure, joy. Pleasure is something as an enjoyment coming from the outside stimuli. That's why food and other things, you take pleasure in that. But when we say joy, it's from within. Pleasure usually is enjoyable siya before the act. After sang act, hindi na siya pleasurable. Food, mag-enjoy ka kay gutom ka. Pero kung busog ka na, hindi ka na mag-enjoy. That's pleasure. May limit. Pero joy, no? Sacrifice siya sa primero. Pero after an act, nag-linger siya. That's the joy of generosity. Fourth benefit, you will receive blessing in proportion to what you give. This is biblical, not necessarily monetary, not necessarily material, because God has His own ways. It's found in 2 Corinthians 9:6. Remember this, a farmer who plants only a few seeds will get a small crop, but the one who plants generously will get a generous crop. So, hindi gani ini supernatural gid, bisan in economics, gatabo na, or agriculture. Okay? Dulaon mong isa mong kasako, then farm mo para mag-produce 20 sacks. Kung di mo nakarunti, paano ka mag-produce? Fifth, God will meet the needs and give you plenty left over to share. That's 2 Corinthians 9:8. And God will generously provide all you need. Then you will always have everything you need and plenty left over to share with others. Hindi ni maintindihan sa mga kuripot. Hindi ni. Ang ginahambal ko ni, kakontra ng mga kuripot. Yan, hindi na tuod. Naubuson ko dira. Of course, spiritual. Di mo nang hambal ni Lord. Kung kasi hindi mo maintindihan, kaya ang measurement mo is the standard of the world. Peter, lain ang standard sa heaven. Isipon mo na karon justice, justice. Da, ano na matabo sa imo na? Muna natuduan ni Jesus si Peter. Six, God will increase your resources partially to increase your giving. Like this one. I like this one. For God is the one who provides seed for the farmer and then bread to eat. In the same way, He will provide and increase your resources and then produce a greatest harvest of generosity in you. 2 Corinthians 9:10. Nanamian siya kung generous ka. Nanamian siya. Kay generous ka man sa iban, hambalya dugangan ko, generous. Hinablos ko mahatag sang birthday gift sa akon. Gamay nga bata, tipon-tipon niya i-allowance kay bakalya gift. Nabalaan ko nga mo lang ginahimo iya. O kaya di kong dugangan ko allowance siya. Oh. You see, not so much nga kinanglan ko ang gift eh, kay ano na, pero kita kong i-effort. So, tungod generous ka, I'll be generous to you. Kaya nagbakal mo gift, halin man na sa akon. Pero happy ako sang iya gift. Turbalan ko akon mana. Iti ako man naghatag mo. Wala ko sang ginhatag, yaman tumabakal. That's why when you're generous, maging generous pagin ang Diyos sa iyo. Seventh, you will bless others and they will praise God. Amian man ko sining reason. Nya kung i-bless mo sila, buligan mo sila, they will praise God because of you. Because of your work. Because of your generosity. Let's start thanking God. Te, nagsimba sila sa Diyos, bangun sa imo generosity. Oh yes, you will be enriched in every way so that you can always be generous. And when we take your gifts to those who need them, they will thank God. 2 Corinthians 9:11. So, imo generosity converts them. Your generosity brings them back to God. Alamian gid ang Dios. Wala ka man sang gin-preach. Wala ka man sang gin-teach. Generous ka lang. But because balanalay si tita, nami palasimba gid si tita, generous siya kay palasimba siya. Thank God, thank you Lord, thank you Lord. Magpa-thank you sila. Tungod generous. And then lastly, the last but not the least, we store up eternal rewards in heaven. When we are generous, ang material things nag-aagi sa aton generosity, gina-transform niya into spiritual grace, spiritual treasures. Hindi mo madalang imo treasures diri sa duta palangit, pero kung mag-aagi siya sa imo generous heart, gina-process ang imo generosity, gina-transform niya spiritual treasures. That's why thank you Lord for this generosity. Kaya mga material things namon, matransform namon sa spiritual merits because of this generosity. From David Livingstone, I place no value on anything I have or may possess except in relation to the kingdom of God. Kanami sini. So, nang manggaranon siya, parang balya, himuon ko ini, magpamanggad, kag mag-enjoy, pero always related to the kingdom of God. That's why ang generosity anchors us to God. Wala generosity, material things lang. Wala kita anchor sa Dios. So that's it. God is generous to us. Justice is not against generosity. It's the minimum of generosity. Justice is the minimum of generosity. But we can go beyond justice. We give because we have received from God. Amen. May your mercy, we beseech you, Lord, be with your people who cry to you, so that what we seek at your promptings, we may obtain by your ready generosity, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.